Introduction. We get fibers from plants and animals. Fiber from plants are cotton, jute, gongura, coconut plant. In the same way, we get fiber from animals like silkworms, sheep, goat, camel, yak, etc. Animal fiber is a protein, while plant fiber is carbohydrate. Moth to eggs. Silk moth is like butterfly. Bombyx mori is another name of these moths. Moths are kept in mesh boxes in separate rooms. They are called as chilakalu. Female moths lay around 500 eggs and dies. These eggs are allowed to hatch in special chambers, usually over mats on the bed of chopped mulberry leaves to get small worms. Silk moths and worms are sold. Farmers from Karnool, Kadapa, Mehboobnagar districts and some other places of our state come and purchase these tiny worms and silk moths to prepare eggs. These centers are called greenages. Egg to cocoon. The worms eat leaves day and night. They need good hygienic condition and proper light to grow. When they grow bigger in size, they are transferred to a big size cane frames called Chandrikalu. After 30 to 35 days, the caterpillar stops eating and settles at a particular place. It weaves a net to hold itself. Caterpillars secrete fiber-like substance from its mouth. When it is exposed to air and heat, it becomes strong. The net is woven completely to cover the body of caterpillar. This seems to be a closed sac. This is called cocoon. The larva of silkworm undergoes changes in the cocoon to change into a moth. After 2 to 3 weeks, moths comes out from cocoons and fly away. If it is done, so the cocoon will be spoiled and farmers will not be able to get a continuous thread of silk from such a cocoon. They won't be able to obtain quality fiber for fabric. Within 2 to 3 days of formation of cocoon, the farmers start removing them from the tray. The farmers kill the larva inside by a process called stifling by putting them in a steam over 10 to 15 minutes to store the cocoons for a long time. Cocoons to fiber. Obtaining silk fiber from cocoon is called reeling. It is done with a special machine called reeler and twister. The silk thread is carefully collected from the cocoons and nearly 3 to 18 of such threads are woven together to make yarn from it, which is reeled. This yarn is cleaned, bleached and colored. The yarn is woven into a variety of designed fibers as looms. The reeling centers are at Nandikotkur, Hyderabad, Karimnagar, etc. The weavers get silk yarn from the reeling centers to weave a variety of saris. Weaving is a traditional occupation. Pochampalli Pattu and Dharmavaram are famous types produced by our state. Pochampalli Pattu is also called tie and dye or jamdani. Dharmavaram is famous for its wide border and rich buta or dots. There are several varieties of silk saris: Banaras, Kanchipuram, Dharmavaram, Kottakota, Narayan Pet, Pochampalli are all types of silk fabrics. They get their names from the places where they are made. Apart from mulberry, Tasar silk is produced in our state. Some chemicals are added to give strength to it. There are several varieties of silk. Tasar silk, Muga silk, Kosa silk, Iri silk, etc. Silk is used to make other products like satin and crepe. There are both hand looms and power looms to weave silk. Wool. Animal fibers are natural fibers. Animal fiber is a protein. Hair of animals like goat, sheep, camel, etc. are used in obtaining woolen fiber. Obtaining hair from the animal is called fleece or fur. It is mainly a protein. Merino sheep is specially rare. Good quality of wool is obtained from merino sheep. The fleece is 3 to 5 inches long and most valuable. In Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Uttaranchal, Arunachal Pradesh, Sikkim, Haryana, Punjab, Rajasthan and Gujarat, the sheep are reared in large farms. During spring season, fleeces of sheep is removed from its body by shearing. The process of removing hair from the body of sheep is called shearing. To prevent damage to the skin, grease is used. Shearing skin with hair is dipped in such tanks and stirred with a spade. Often, it is washed under a stream of water. This water contains some chemicals to remove grease, dirt and dust. This process is called washing or scanning. After washing, cool air is passed over the wool, which makes it softer. The broken and long ones like twigs, bits of leaves, unwashed materials, etc. are separated out in process called sorting or woolen classing. The woolen fibers are bleached and then dyed with different colors. The colored fibers are used to make yarn. These fibers are then combined through combining machine. Wool is pulled through many teeth of combining machine. After combining, a machine rolls and pulls it out, twists it into a long thread. This is the process of spinning. The thread is woven up on drilling spools. Then the yarn is dyed before weaving. By making knots with loops and rings of long threads of yarn, woolen fibers are knitted. In addition to hand-to-hand made process of knitting, weaving also takes place. Hand looms and power looms are also used on which woolen yarn is woven to fiber. Woolen threads are stretched from the top of loom to the bottom. These are called wrap threads. The threads that go side to side are weft threads. A shuttle-like big needle takes the weft threads over and under wrap threads. One more important part of the loom is the harness. The harness lifts every other wrap thread so that the weft thread go over one and under the next. All type of yarn, whether cotton or silk or wool, are woven in this manner. Uses. Wool is a poor conductor of heat. Air trapped in between the woolen fibers and our body prevents the flow of heat and protects from cold. Woolen cloth also helps to douse fire. So, we wrap a person who is caught in fire with a blanket.
మా వీడియో గనుక మీకు నచ్చినట్లయితే లైక్ చేయండి, షేర్ చేయండి. ఇలాంటి మరిన్ని వీడియోస్ కోసం మా ఛానల్ని సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేసుకోవడం మాత్రం మర్చిపోకండి. థ్యాంక్ యూ ఫర్ వాచింగ్.